Hi there. In this lesson in Excel, we're going to talk about lines and borders and just some of the fun stuff you can do with it. And what we're going to focus on in this lesson is just adding a little bit more depth to this spreadsheet, you know, getting the lines in there where we want them and changing the color of those lines as well. So let's start with our first example being all of the data within our spreadsheet, not including the totals, not including the titles, but the rest of the data, we do want to have lines around it. And let's just start with how that's going to look. So I'm going to start at the top here. If I go Control A, it goes a little bit too far because it includes my total line, which I don't want to include. So I can just go Shift click just above there on that corner here. So that's something to keep in mind as a shortcut. So I want to have this area that I want to put all lines around. So I'm going to go to my borders button up here. And if I say all borders, it's going to give me the plain old black borders. And I want to kind of get fancier than that. I don't want to just do black borders. So I'll click on it just so you can see what I'm talking about. And then we're going to do it again. We'll undo it and then do it again. But we'll change up the color. We'll change it to white. We'll change it to another color and see what you like. All right, so you should see the black borders everywhere. If you click somewhere, that can verify that all the borders around all the cells are in that color. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna undo that and we're gonna actually look for changing the color of these borders to white just to see how much of a difference this could make to your spreadsheet. So let's try that. So just go ahead and undo. Okay, and we'll select that area again. And before we choose the borders we want to choose the color. So we're going to go into line color here, and then lots of colors to choose from. We're going to pick the white color, which is right there before the black color. And so now we have a pencil where we could actually draw a border anywhere on our screen, but we don't want to do that. We actually just want to go back to the borders and pick the border that we want to use. So everything is still selected. So it's just kind of in limbo waiting for us. We're going to choose all borders. And then if you click somewhere else, you should see that it's all in white for the borders in between each of these rows and in between each of these columns. So it looks kind of cool, doesn't it? So let's try a few other choices here. I have the color coding kind of between the text and the dollar amounts of stuff and the reorder dates and so on. But let's say I want to kind of, you know, even drill that home a little bit further. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put a dark shade of the blue, say to the right of my text columns, and then I can do maybe a dashed red color on the discontinued column. So this way we can kind of practice how do we draw the lines in those particular colors and in those particular ways. So let's start with the blue column. I'm just going to zoom out a bit so I can see the bottom. Okay, so let's click on B6 is what I'm on, but it's wherever the category heading is, and select all the way to the bottom of that second column, C. And that looks like row 65 for me that I'm going down to. And then we're going to go into our lines, our borders button again. But this time we're going to go pick the color, and then we're going to pick the style of border we want. And then we're going to draw it where we want it to go. So let's go in here, line color, and let's find the darkest blue that we have there. So I'll just pick the bottom, well, maybe the second bottom one. And then I got my pencil again, so I'm going to go back into my borders drop down. And I can right now just say right border if I want, and that'll just be to the right of whatever I have selected. But I kind of want a little bit more than just that. That's just a basic right border. I might want a different style for that line. So I'm going to go to the line style option, and it let me pick a different style if I want. So let's say I want to do the double line. And now if I go again for the third time, going back to the borders button, and if I say right border, that will then remember that color, remember that style, and it'll put it to the right of what I have selected. So let's try that. So now I'm going to zoom out, unselect. So until you unselect, you won't really see it. And I do have a double blue line showing there. Not bad, not bad. Okay, well let's do a little bit more here. We're gonna do the same kind of thing with discontinued, but I'm gonna have us go right into the menu to do all the choices. We'll kind of do it in one place. So I'm gonna select this area. So you don't have to zoom out if you don't want to. I'll select at the top of discontinued. I'll scroll down to the bottom here. And then just shift click. So it selects that area. And then I'll go into my borders button. And so rather than doing it one at a time, again, I'm gonna go to more borders here. And then I'm gonna pick these things that I want. So I'm gonna pick the color. And it's showing nothing right now because remember I have white borders everywhere. That's why it looks so funny when I go in here. So I'm gonna pick red, maybe that shade of red. And now I see the styles that I can choose from. So let's pick one of the dash styles. Okay. And now I have kind of a sampling of where do you want it. And so I want it on the left side. So I'm just kind of clicking on the left side. So pretend this is like one cell. Actually it's two cells is what it's showing as. And then I want I don't want it at the top, sorry. Left side and then on the right side. So I'm just gonna make sure I click in the right area. And I could have, as if you notice down here, there is a button that was in our menu that represents the left side and the right side. So I could have picked those ones as well. But wherever you click is where it's going to draw that line. So that would kind of be like almost all the areas. I don't want that. Okay, so let's choose OK and see what we get. So again, until you click somewhere else, you won't see the difference. And there you go. Yeah, not sure if I like that, but it's got some pizzazz around it, right? So, okay, and let's do one more example with the title line, and maybe that one will just make it a white border, which we already have, but maybe we'll make it a bit thicker, so it kind of has a bit of a separation from the title to all the data. So selected the first one, and then we'll go to the last one. And we can go to our borders again. And then we can go to our line color again. So we can do it one by one this time and pick the white color and we get the pencil. Don't worry, go back into your line color again. And we want a thick bottom border. So we could choose that or we could choose line style. And if we choose line style, then we can go down to the, which is probably the same as the thick line border. So I'll choose that one. Okay, line style. And now the third thing we have to do is say where we want it. So we want it underneath. So it's a bottom border. So we're gonna click on that. And if I click somewhere else, you see, yeah, there's a bit of an extra attention put to that separation between there. So if I change my mind about, you know, having the blue show up on the titles and the red show up on the titles here for the borders, I can click on that particular cell, go to my borders button again, go to more borders, and it shows me that it's using the blue double line there. So I can say, I don't want that. I want to go back to the white one. So I can click on white, which it kind of is on, and then just click there. And then choose OK, and it's back to not having that. Let's do the same thing with this one. So on that one cell, I'm just clicked on that one cell. I'm going to go here to the borders drop down, more borders. And if I want white, I'm going to change my color first because right now it's on red. Change it to white. And it kind of doesn't matter what style I'm picking because it's white. So you notice it's still on that dash style, but who cares? We're going to click on that one, click on that one, choose OK, click somewhere else. Oh, actually, it does matter, huh? Well, good lesson there. Good, that's good that we did that. So let's click on that again and go back to more borders. Let's put a color on it like black and let's just pick the normal, that one, because that would have been what our normal white would have been, was that thickness. So pick the one that it should have been. And then I'll pick white. And now I'll click on the left side and the right side. Hard to tell what I'm doing because it's white. Let's see if it worked. Okay, seems to have worked. So there you have it. You know, play around with the borders. Take note of the fact that below all the different types of borders you have the option of, you can obviously erase borders too, but we were playing around with the line color, the line style, and then we were picking the border we wanted or going in deeper to actually hand pick it. So those are some extra options for you to make your spreadsheets look even more amazing. Okay, have fun with that.